Good afternoon, everybody. As far as data, analytics, technology is concerned, advancement in this sector is concerned, it is very, very important for every sector. And that is also the case true in the solar sector also, power sector also. Without advancement in technology, without use of data technology, no sector can survive in such a competitive environment. As far as if I talk about some decades before, it was very important to take a decision. People don't used to take a decision if for anything, any product you are buying, any service you are getting, you used to take a decision, it was considered worthful. After some time, the scenario changed. If few decades back, what happened? It was very important to take quality decision. Another Q got added to D and it was made quality decision. You may take some time in taking decision, but that decision should be quality decision. But now in present scenario, in this so much competitive environment, another Q has also been added to it and it is becoming QQD. You need to take quick quality decision. You can't, and for taking this quick quality decision, you need to rely on the information that you are getting. For getting this information, you need to take support of technology, you need to take support of data analytics, which is the source of information. Because only QQD decision, quick quality decision making can be taken only on the basis of information that you are getting. So in this sector also, this is for taking decision, information is required. We have tested use of technology in various fields in our power plants. Earlier talk was going about the module cleaning cycle also, soiling loss. What we have discovered, we can't even fix the module cleaning cycle as per not on the basis of in state which our plant is located, not on the basis of the area specific area, but it also depends upon the tables also. If we are look, our few of the tables are located along the roadside or on the boundary of the fence, in that area a larger number of module cleaning cycles are required. So how we were able to gather this data with the help of applying technology and gathering data, how much losses we are getting, and even we, in some cases we have come to a conclusion that even three module cleaning has to be implemented after every 3 to 4 days also. Earlier we used to do it in 15 days and there has been such much increase in our revenue after implementing module cleaning cycle in a span of 3 to 4 days also. Another dimension that has been also coming to the solar sector is the forecasting and scheduling regulations. Forecasting and scheduling regulations have been implemented in the state of Karnataka. They have also come in various other parts of the country. Rajasthan is about to start it from 1st February, DSM charges a large amount of penalties. And large bandwidth depends upon how you forecast your energy, how you forecast your solar power, how you forecast your wind energy. All these things depend upon your generation data. The generation data, if you're getting this data accurately, you will be able to predict handsomely. If you're not getting these details, you will not be able to predict. In the state of Chhattisgarh, if you talk, few of the developers are having a penalty to the tune of 30% of their rate of PPAs per month. They are getting penalties. So for another dimension of scheduling and forecasting, data analytics, data gathering is very much required. We have also studied some of the, even if we talk about the module efficiency, various module makers predict that efficiency will be given at the STC conditions. And STC conditions stand for temperature taken at the 25 degrees Celsius. But in Indian scenario, most of the time for the months of this May to August, we are getting temperature of around 40, 45. So there is a huge loss in this generation capacity. So with the deployment of various technologies and we have inbuilt some of the factors, we developed this and we implemented, planting of aloe vera, various gels we have appointed at our plants, and our efficiency and from the module generation has increased to substantial numbers, helping us in our revenue enhancement. Secondly, in security also, plants of area five acres is required for implementing of 1 megawatt of plant. So these plants are very huge capacities, and just of this around 7 to 10 security guards can't manage these plants. So we are also trying to have this security also webcams and various security features, advanced security features also get implemented at various plants, because security is also a very major issue these days. A lot of rural, because these plants are mostly located in the rural sector, and as far as you know, in changing scenario, few of the plants are having tariff of rupees 12 per unit, and whereas the people now expect a tariff of rupees 3 units, 3, 4 rupees. A lot of agitations, a lot of issues, community issues, civil issues are being cropping up. So as to another, we are also making use of technology in security sector also. Next is, for example, we have also implemented the use of technology. We have mostly our plants have fixed module structure. So, but with the advent of technology, we have also partnered with some of the foreign agencies. We are transforming our fixed angle into seasonal tilt and single axis tracking system. So it has also given the few of the pilot projects that we have implemented, they have given us around 30% increase in our revenue share from the same system itself. So for taking all these decisions, for managing these plants in a better way, technology is very, very much required these days. Thank you.